Hey guys, today I wanted to talk about arrangement and maybe something around the topic. I'm trying to building a track and show some hints and tricks along the way. And yeah, please don't judge me by the results of the track. It's basically built in front of your eyes just for the purpose of showing these examples. So I'm starting at the bottom of the track with the bass line or with the sub bass, and we are going then step by step to the top. So let's start by adding one instrument track, and we are adding one polysynth, and this is our bass synth. And the first thing you maybe notice is I don't use the arranger window, I'm using the clip launcher. So add one clip and add the bass note, and we are trying to stay in A minor. So that's okay for now. And the second thing we are trying to create is a kick drum. And we are tuning this kick drum to A1 because we are in A minor. And that's maybe the first thing you maybe notice, that our clips have pretty unusual length. It's basically reduced to the shortest possible clip length without having to duplicate the information inside of the clips. So I'm having pretty much one note in each clip, but you can already hear we have some kind of groove going on without doing much besides choosing unusual clip length, okay? As you can see, we don't really need the right arranger window to create our first 4-bar main loop. We can pretty much stay on the left side in the clip launcher. But let's move on to make this clip of the clap clip a bit more dynamic. And usually you then do this by make this clip longer, maybe this, 2 bars. And then try to alternate it at the end. But in this tutorial, I want to show you some unusual things. So let's remove this and make this clip again half a bar long. And then we duplicate this. And and we alternate the second clip. So we have two clips, the original one and the duplicated one with the alternation of the notes. And then we select the first clip again, go to the left side on next action, and we are choosing 3 and 2. And this means basically 3 bars and a half bar. 4 is 1 bar, 3.2. And after this clip played 3 bars and a half bar, we are twice Bitwig to play the next clip. And the next clip is this, and this clip is playing exactly for half a bar. And then Bitwig should start with the first clip. So let's play this. So you can see we already done some arrangement work inside our clip launcher without touching the arranger window at all. Let's move on by duplicating this alternate clip again and then alternate it further. Maybe like this. And then we go back to our first clip. And we are choosing, instead of next, we are choosing other. And this means Bitwig is trying to play after this clip some other clip. Maybe this, maybe this, I don't know. So, and this is of course starting always after half a bar with the first one. So let's try this out. So you just created some random arrangement, and there is a part of surprise in there, even for you, the creator, and it's pretty fun to do. Of course, we can do this with all other clips too. So maybe our kick clip here, we can drag it out and duplicate it, and we create an alternate version of it. And this time, this clip is not like this clip, 2 quarters long or half a bar. This clip is 1 quarter long. So we want to repeat this 8 bars, but not quite, 1 quarter shorter. So we have 7 bars and 3 quarters long. And after this clip, we want to play random. And this clip is playing 1 quarter long, and after it played, we want to have the first one selected. So let's try this. So the difference between play random and play other is basically that this clip has a chance of being played again after this clip is played. And this clip is sometimes playing, but not always. This of course works also for musical stuff. So let's try to separate our drums from the musical stuff with selecting all the drums, drum tracks, and hitting Control and G to group them, so we can mute everything and rename this maybe, and let's focus on the musical stuff. So we have our bass here, and of course there's only one note in it, and it's a bit boring. So we duplicate this, and we want the first pattern to play four bars, play the next, and the next clip is also played four bars, and then play the first. And the second clip, we choose a different note. Because we are in A minor, we are choosing a different note in A minor. Let's try this. Okay, this works. And let's try to create one lead synth. Polysynth. There it is. I'm cloning this. No, don't need this. Maybe choose a quarter for this. And maybe some FX. And maybe randomize the sound itself. Just a touch. Rename this and then duplicate this. Duplicate this, play this maybe two bars, then play the next. Play this maybe also two bars, and then play other, duplicate this, also two bars. Let's try. Sound is always nice. After one bar, play random. Thank you. Yeah, sorry, this was some kind of creativity explosion right there. Sorry for that. But I want to close this video at this point because there's so much more I can tell. And I want to do this maybe in another video. And you can see this technique is pretty interesting to come up with nice arrangements on the fly without putting in too much work in the arrangement window. So try this for yourself. And if you learned something today in this video, then please leave me a like or subscribe to the channel. And until next time, see you. Bye.